Let's talk Kaiser. Are we talking Kaiser Vanguard? Nope. What do you mean? Nope. Not the Vanguard. Not the high end. Below the Vanguard series now is their new Laconic series. And that's what this is. The submarine. It's the submarine. I like this design. This is interesting, isn't it? Almost, kind of a weird, like Torbay look, design type thing. To me, at least it seems. And I imagine this is in-house. When they're that cheap, you just ain't got no money for designer stuff. Here it is. No jimping on the flipper tab. Flipper tab's pretty easy to use. And definitely hits you in the thumb. It's over the detent ball. Here she comes. Boom! Fell all the way home. Got the typical Kaiser drop, though, right? How did they do this? How did they do this? It's like, yeah, not all your knives are going to do that. Your Kaiser ones will probably. But you know what? Not all the others necessarily. It's just, check this out. Right in there, right? The submarine, right and left hand, deep carry, flat as a bat, right there. Obviously tapered screws, so they'll flatten out, go in your pocket. Nice pocket clip design, deep carry, not a huge knife, not a heavy knife, easy to flick, finger flick, got the little cutaway here. Got you a thumb ramp, nice and comfortable. Ergos, yeah, no problem there. 9CR18, so it's a stainless, it's nice and corrosion resistant. It's something that Civivi and Zencut have used a lot on their knives as well, so it's not like it hasn't been out there. Pull it. Okay. No, it's got a good factory edge on it. Yeah, that's good. That's good. I mean, not scary sharp, but probably edges upwards a little bit from most of the standard factory sharpness that I've seen. So I like it. I like this fuller coming out, this kind of whatever this is up here. You got a little cutaway down here for sharpening, etc., etc. Well, we got a nested liner lock. I don't think. Oh, yeah, we don't have a liner on the top at all. So we probably got a little inset or something to support the pivot. And so the Laconic series, the only other one I have is this one here, the Swedge, and I have a video on this as well. Did I already mess up this end of the box? Okay, the Swedge. So these are just common sense, usable, easy carry knives. They're not huge, but they're not small, and they're no nonsense, but they're Kaiser quality. Yeah. Remember when they had the Tangram series? That went away. It was weird, but people were liking it. They were using that Akuto, Japanese Akuto 440 or whatever on some of their blades. But yeah, this is nice. 3 point, what is it? Okay, so White Mountain Knives, you got it. They're in stock, or at least they are right now. $48 minus 10%. LTK is your discount code. So almost $5 off. So low 40s. They don't charge tax or shipping. So you're in low 40s, okay? Territory. And the 7.4 overall length, 3.2, 9CR18, blah, 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 3.2. So 3.2, is it? No, nothing else. Okay. 3.2 ounces. Is that the truth? Or is it a lie? And it's the truth. And 91.7 grams. Now, 3.2. Well, at least it's bigger than a 3. Well, I mean, there's 3.25. There's 3.35, probably. There's 7 and 3/8, okay? And 18.7 centimeters, okay? So, yeah, it's not real big, but, you know, really, that's pretty good full-size blade for most applications, I'd say. And it's light, and it's fidget-friendly, and, she definitely drops. And no blade play or lock rock. Seems pretty solid lockup. And there it is. And that's 30%, 30 to 35%, so nothing to cry about there. And you know what? It also seems relatively slender in the hand. And there it is, yeah. Right there, like a paramilitary 2. Exactly the same, okay. 11.7 millimeters, so it's under 12. Yeah, 2.7. I always call that like 3 millimeter, but it's 2.7 at 0.10. So, okay, there's your blade stock. Easy. Easy breezy, laconic. The submarine. I'd say so far, I mean, I've only got the swedge and the sub, you know, so far. I'll definitely call it for the submarine. I'm liking this. This design, yeah. I mean, there's a little pizzazz in here. And I know there's supposed to be kind of a no-nonsense, you know, just get as decent a knife for the money as you can. And, you know, I mean, there's a race involved there because there's a lot of good stuff. Best Techman's got some stuff. I like the Good Boy. And, you know, CJRB makes some decent ones. And then the Sencut line is no doubt. I love the Sencut stuff too. And Civivi even makes some that get into the 40s, okay? And they're part of the Sencut Wii group anyhow. So this is nice. And so I think we did take the swedge apart. So let's real quick take a gander at this one. And yeah, let's see if we can disassemble the box. I think it's all T8s. Kidding you. I'm kidding you. Okay, let's take a look in the box, though. Ugh. You Ben Ed, buddy. God, that's cool. I don't have a sticker wall. I mean, I got a patch wall, so for, but yeah. Okay, now, you even get extra hardware. God dang it. Never happy, never happy. And a microfiber cloth in there too, okay. And just in case, a sticker. Okay, you can have the sticker. What else we got in here? Oh, okay. And the Laconic series. There you go. Simplicity, utility. Seriously, yes. So there's that. Goes in a box, easy to do. Come here, and let's see if we're gonna bust something apart. What are we gonna bust apart? Right here, that's gonna work, right there. We're out of screws. Oh, we got a pocket screw, and that's about it. It probably, that top one goes through that standoff there, doesn't it? Is it gonna be a 6? Most pocket screws are. Hold on, come on. You got to find it first. Okay. But I'll take the other one off too. Even though that probably just goes into the liner. Okay. Well, they're both the same length, aren't they? Okay. Oh, here it is back here. That's the one. It was hiding under the pocket clip, you coward. Okay, no one of the pocket clip ones are the same length. Okay, but that looks no different in length either. But that was just plain ass going through that standoff. Okay, now let's do this because it's super simple, right? Bang, there's a lock bar side. G10. And there's your... Oh, okay, look at this. They got an internal, huh? Oh, you're getting schmancy on me now, huh? Come here. Bang, bang, bang. Okay, now are you going to come off? Now? Could you possibly? Oh, you know what? Let's go get my fiddler. There you go. See? You can't stop the fiddler. Okay, there you go. Oh, we just pulled the stop out too. Okay. We pulled out all the stops. And ceramic bearing. There's you a pivot that's captured. And yes, it is right through there. And we got ceramic bearings too. So ceramic bearings, captured pivot, and this don't push through because this unscrews from this end too. And then you got a squared off piece that goes into each side, okay? But there is no liner here. And you see how they mounted these screws in here? Right into the G10, okay? So that does change things a little bit. Let me see. Yeah, there's, this is, God, I just got that, didn't I? Whoa! Yes, I did. I got that, and oh, look at this. God, that's a powerful magnet there. But yeah, it took everything with it. But yeah, on this side, of course, you got to have this washer, because you're right up against the G10. But the other side, of course, you don't, because you already got, you know, steel. So you're good. There's your disassembly. Submarine. Yeah, real drop shutty. Not too big, not too small. And priced for all of you all. Okay, it rhymed at least. Love them knives here. You guys, stay sharp.